Welcome here in London with Yamaha. We have just launched a new product here at the London Japan House. We are talking about a couple of new products. You see them in the background. It's DM7 and DM7 Compact. So a small form factor and a somewhat larger form factor console. The smallest one is 72 channels and the bigger one is 120 channels. 48 mix buses, 12 matrixes, and a lot of features. Apart from that, we have also launched a control unit, which is called DM7 Control, and that can be docked as an option to the compact console as well as to the larger format console, and that will give you extra user-defined controls, user-defined keys, transport control, a joystick, two extra faders, and it is an expansion pack for the hardware unit. Alongside of that, we have launched two specific firmware update packages. One is the broadcast specific package and the other one is theater. So both of them have specific features for specific applications. They will be separately available and can be installed in the mixer, can be installed also at the same time in one mixer. And they come as free when the control unit is bought. So that's the DM7 system. Very specific feature for this console is the so-called split mode. So what that means is that the actual engine inside the console can be split into two independent engines. So basically you have one engine, which is divided into engine A and engine B. And each of the engines have access to specific input channels or output channels, but they have halved the number of channels. And then you can determine how many mixes are available in engine A and how many mixes are available in engine B. So that makes it very easy to, for example, have a show and do a live stream at the same time. So an industry event you are running on engine B with its own settings and its own scenes, for example. And at the same time, you're doing a stream out to the internet and you have a separate engine being responsible for that. So that is one very important feature in this console. So the system is obviously based on Dante. We are completely compatible to the Rio units and all the third-party microphone receivers and stuff like that. So that is the same as you know from the other Yamaha products. 144 channels in total, so 144 inputs at 96 kilohertz and 144 outputs at 96 kilohertz. We offer all that within the package, and the price for that for a compact version is 14,000 euro approximately, and for the larger one is 27,000 euro approximately, excluding VAT. Shipping for the consoles will be around September, and the shipping of the control unit, including the software packages, will be around December approximately.
Hey, thanks for watching. My name's Andy Cooper. I'm part of the research and development team with Yamaha. We're having a look at the DM7 series. This is the larger of the consoles. My favorite thing here is the selected channel view. So in the screen, 12.1 inch multi-touch, we can just see so much detail for one channel. Here's the EQ. Of course, we can move it around and adjust on the screen, or we have the encoders below for further adjustment. But I can quickly go here, and here's Dynamics 1, my noise gate, and I can make adjustment like this, or Dynamics 2 here. I can fold it open and have adjustments here so easily, and I can fold it back down again like that. But look, along the top, you can see the whole signal flow. You've got your input, you've got phantom power, you've got analog gain, digital gain, dynamics and EQ. Inserts will be there. Delay there, pan, fader, and here are all your sends. So you have 48 mix sends and 12 matrix in a DM7. I'm in split mode right now, hence the blue coloring, so it's split into two virtual consoles. But hey, touch here, and you can open up your sends. You can drag your send levels there, or you can preset them to fixed levels like that, quick and easy. And you can hide the ones that are not sending with that button there. So just from the selected channel, you can do so much so quickly, and it's nice, colorful, and clear. There's three sections to the rack. We've got premium, we've got effects, and we've got EQ. In the premium rack, there are up to 64 channels worth of plugins. And here we can see loads of dynamics, including Rupert Neve compressors, virtual circuitry modeling, multi-band compressor, and the dance dynamic noise suppressor is available there. Also, we've got a whole range of EQs. Again, Rupert Neve designs, other ones, dynamic EQ there, for example. Then we have reverbs and delays available as well, including the open deck tape saturation plugin there. So that's the first part of the rack. We've got the effects rack where we've got reverbs and delays available there, 16 units of that. And we've got the EQ rack, 32 units of EQ rack, or up to 64 channels for parametric EQs and graphic EQs. And of course, we can put them on the faders for easy adjustment like that. So that's a really powerful processing rack in there. Where's the Dugan auto mixer? You may be asking. Well, you can access it right from the channel strip. It's always inserted post fader, available for you, ready to go. 64 channels of Dan Dugan auto mixer. Thanks for watching. My name's Andy Cooper. Find out more on Yamaha's website.